Okay guys, I'm going to be going over the features of the vertebrae and the three regions of the vertebral column. So just looking at this large vertebrae here, the common features you should be able to identify. Here is the body, this solid bone part. This hole here is the vertebral foramen. When all of them are together, we call them, as it lines up and makes a tunnel, the vertebral canal. Right here is the spinous process. So this would be pointing towards your back. These two here and here are the transverse processes. I'm going to turn it to the side so you can kind of see these other features. Lean it over a little bit. All right. So coming in this way, looking at the side view again, here is the body. Here is the spinous process. The transverse process is coming out towards you, towards the screen. And now I can see some other features. So right here, this little space here is the inferior vertebral notch. And when it is put together with this little notch that's on the superior surface, we end up making one of these, which is an intervertebral foramen. So notice it takes the inferior notch of the one above, that little superior notch of the one below, and a disc to make enough space for this hole. And what I'm pushing on right now is a nerve that would be going through the intervertebral foramen. Okay, now where they come together, we have this surface that is sticking up here on the top. This is called the superior articular facet. And then right here off of the spinous process are these parts here. This is the inferior articular facet. So those are all the common features of any vertebra. Okay, now we're going to go into the special features for the individual regions. So for the cervical region, which is the first seven vertebrae, the first thing you notice is that there's an artery running through the side of the transverse process here, only in the neck region. So after we get past the cervical region, we no longer see that artery in there. So the hole that's running through the transverse process is right here, and we're going to call that the transverse foramen. That would be on all of the cervical vertebrae. So here's cervical vertebra 1, and here is cervical vertebra 2, and you can kind of look, I have to go to the side, but they are there. There's my transverse foramen. Okay, let's go back to cervical vertebra 1. This one is really special. It's called Atlas, just like the mythological character who had to hold up the world. This is the first vertebra of the spinal column that holds up the skull. So this is Atlas C1. And here is the transverse foramen, let you know it's from the cervical region. And right here, I have these two little cups. Those are the superior articular facets of the atlas. Okay, C2 is also special. That's this one. This one is known as axis, because what we can do is we can take atlas and place it, let me move my camera here, place it over axis, and then it can rotate. So again, this is atlas, and this one is called, the whole bone is called axis. And the part that it rotates around right here is called the dens or odontoid process. So those are the features you need to know for the cervical vertebrae. And on this string, I'm having kind of trouble because everything's connected. I have one representative of the next region, that is here. And I taught my lab, you see a face here, you can kind of see a giraffe face. And so this is a thoracic vertebrae known as the thoracic giraffe. And what's different about this, it has all the common features, except now we have to add in a connection point for the rib, the costa. So we have costal facets. And so one part of the rib touches here on the back of the transverse process. So this is one costal facet. And then another part of the rib touches right here on the side of the body. That is the other costal facet of a thoracic vertebra. The final group of vertebra belong to the lumbar region. And see here, I call this my lumbering moose. You can see a moose face. And there are no special features that you need to know for this region. You just need to be able to identify all of the common features.